It wouldn't appear so, but there's very fine similarities between the thinking of playing a guitar and the charade.
East meets West. Two legends unite to see what a collaboration would sound like. Join them now as they discuss their journey, the story that brought them together, and hear the results.
I wanted to start out before we dive into specifics about the music itself and talk a little bit about how it came together. Now, so did somebody just say, is there a guitarist in the house?
No, you know what? It just kind of happened. Through George Harrison, spiritual contacts in India, they arranged for me to go to India with my wife. And during that, I met Ayan first.
Yes, I think, it was me.
Ayan came over with the sarod and sat down, and we just visited and started a very lasting friendship. And I met Aman also, and then they said, you got to meet our dad. And it wouldn't appear so, but there's very fine similarities between the thinking of playing a guitar and the sarod.
It's the same family.
The mechanics of it are very different, but the wavelength, the part of the universe that you have to be in, we all had in common.
Well, I'm really interested in that too, of how that began.
We didn't really have a plan. We just let it happen. And whatever that was, we rode it, R-O-D-E. We just got on the wagon and let it happen.
The tradition allow innovation. So there is a room because music has connected the world. And thank God, we generally don't deal with the language. We are connected through sound only.
I'm interested, Amjad, in what you said about innovation, because in the Western classical music tradition, you know, it's so tied up in written scores, very specific music that the musicians play, the conductor leads. And I wanted you to talk a little bit about the role of improvisation.
You see, improvisation is okay, and it is nothing great. Even children can improvise. I always had a lot of respect and admiration for jazz music. They also improvise, but they have the freedom to use all the 12 notes, musical notes, the way they want. But in Indian classical music, we are allowed to improvise only within the set room of ascending and descending. If it is five notes, then within five notes we improvise. If it is seven notes, so like that.
Joe, I want to ask you now, moving on to this, your invitation, bringing them here to see what might happen. I mean, did you have a concrete sense that we're going to be able to make something that we want to share?
I didn't know exactly what we were going to do. I didn't really have a plan. I just knew that something profound would come out of this. And at first, none of us had a clue because their music scale is different than Western. They have notes that we don't, you know? They have notes in between our notes that a music professor will say, no, that note doesn't exist. Well, yes, it does. And also, we, in our Western thinking, we love songs that you count to four. Right? All our stuff is four or three, four bars, 16 bars. That's very boring to Indian music. They have stuff in 11. For us, that's like, you want a what? So all of these things we were up against, and we had to figure out what Amjad was doing melodically and rhythmically. And I'm talking about the other musicians that were on board. And at first, it was a kind of a train wreck. But trying to intellectually figure out what to do, try to write it down on music paper or anything, none of that worked. And we found if we ignored all of that and just played, things started to happen. The more we just listened to each other, And whatever that was, whatever came out of us was what worked. And that's what these musical pieces reflect.
How challenging was it on your end, Amjad, Aman? It seems to me like it might be more challenging for the rock guys, the Western pop musicians, because you do have this more complex, more refined musical scale that you're bringing to the table. It's easier to simplify something than it is to make it more complex.
You see, as Joe mentioned, that there are in between notes, between do, re, mi, like that. So, you know, in Indian music, generally people talk about improvisation, but more than improvisation, the slides and glides, that is most important feature of Indian classical music. Like the So these slides and glides, they are very humble, very graceful expressions. It's almost the way Indian people say namaskar with folded hand. So this grace is very, very important.
Joe, you mentioned this feeling of spirituality in the collaboration as you were, you know, finding your way through this. And I was wondering, did you have a sense of that going into this, or did it emerge as you started to play together?
Yes. It was Swami Radhanath. Fortunately, all the, generally the spiritual people are connected with music. And while we were recording, we could see him. He was moving here and there and from different directions and looking and enjoying. So, you know, we believe, especially in our country, whatever good, bad points India we have, but we believe in blessings and we believe in good wishes. And in India, we say Swar Hi Ishwar Hai. That sound connects you to God.
I think spiritually, all of us followed Amjad. Amjad is a profound grandmaster of his instrument and of that tradition. And I just kind of followed his lead and tried to get inside that. The alternative to that would be total panic, you know?
One of the elements that interests me, Amjad, Ayan, and Aman, were there places where all three of you are playing at the same time? If there are three sarod players together, I mean, I'm picturing, you know, three lead guitarists on stage, and this can be either a pinnacle or a disaster. How do they work together?
Any collaboration is only possible if we have love and respect for each other. And three sarod, every individual, they have a different way of expression. So in the symphony orchestra also, all three of us sit together and we play our different roles. So this is what is called harmony and love and peace.
Amjad, would you talk about Healing Love, the song that you did vocals on?
All of us sometimes we are obsessed with some melody and we feel as if we have composed it or we have created it. But I think it comes from some cosmic powers, you know, that melody which I used to hum. Ga ba da sa ni da ba da pa ma ga. So we can continue, we can go on and on and on. So this is what music is all about. It's not always mechanical. It's not always technical. So that is why it becomes spiritual also.
Well, that's very, very enticing. And I know people haven't heard this yet, but when they do, I think the chorus of music listeners like me will grow to hear more. So,
thank you so much.
God willing, yes. I hope this works out. Thank all of you. Thank you guys. Thank you guys for doing this.
We got it all.
I'm John. Thank you. Ayan, Aman. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Marjorie. Thank you, Joe.
Bye, everybody.